Well, I have Mr. Bhalla Dev here with me.
Sir, thank you very much.
What the nation is talking about your body and your beefed up look for Baahubali too.
Well, it's for when you get a character like that, you have to do all it takes to be that. Hmm. And I was in the film, I'm a warlord, I fight wars at an age of 50, 55 and yeah, I need to look the part. Hmm. And the first part did so extremely well, I had to put an extra effort in. Give something which is more edgy and better and cooler.
And is it real? For real or is it?
So I put some training videos and all of them up. Oh. When we were in, so Kunal was my trainer. He's been a trainer for 7 years of my life. Mm. And so he's kind of understood my body. He wants to figure. So whenever I have to build, when I have to come down, so all of those are. Mm.
And what was your diet?
It's kind of different because it was over, this was done over a 6 month period. Mm. So the first couple of months we used to load up as much food as we can. So I used to eat about 7, 8 to 9 meals a day. Mm. Almost. So breaking into every 2, 2.5 hours I used to eat food. Mm. So it was 2 sessions of training for about 4, 5 months. Mm. And then after that we cut all carbs off and then so it was like zero carb for almost a month, I'd say a month and a half, about 6 weeks. Mm. And then the big war was going on and the day I finished, that's the last day that I went to the gym or I saw Kunal.
Yeah, you're thin down now.
Yeah, this is for another film. I'm shooting for a political drama. Oh. And you can't look like a politician who looks like that. Yeah. So we took some time off in the film. I dropped a lot of weight and then started.
Talking about bad. Baladev has sort of become a role model for a lot of people. They feel that there's some goodness in badness.
Yeah, of course. I mean, like any movie goer, I mean, when I was growing up watching movies, you have certain fascination with certain bad people, and especially in franchise movies. Mm. And really, Baahubali is really a franchise film. It's beyond the stars, beyond anybody. It's really a franchise that people are looking out to. And when I get a character that's written so beautifully, mm. I mean, I don't have enough words to thank Vijayendra Prasad, Rajamouli Garu and all of them to have written something so beautiful. And
yeah, I think it's one of the most powerful villain roles in Indian cinema.
I think so too, and I'm very happy that I'm that.
But you had no hesitation in doing this role because why?
Yeah, honest, because at that point by logic, if you see, I mean, I was 3 years into movies. Mm. I did a couple of films, some did well, some not so well. Mm. But this was like a bold move to make at that point. I mean, to play an antagonist, to play a villain in a mainstream movie and go away from cinema for about 3 years or at least that time we thought it's 3, it ended up at 5.
Yeah.
But it was, but then post that I realized, I mean, just to the idea of taking this decision, you know, no one is going to make cinema this size anytime soon. Mm. And at the idea level, when Rajamouli had, when sir had narrated it the first time, he actually narrated it very interestingly. He showed me a map and he started telling the story. Mm. So he showed me a map of this kingdom called Maheshmati that is surrounded by mountains on all three sides. And one side there is a water drop, a water drop where the people from the ground look like it's water coming from the skies. And for me, that's where the story began. Mm. And then he narrated the story. So, I mean, for me, he was doing something really brave, bold, and I think it could change cinema forever. And I said, somehow I need to be a part of it.
Mm. So that's
and there you go, and I jumped in.
Okay, now the action scenes in Baahubali are supposed to be its highlight.
Right.
Explain to me.
So unlike part one, I mean, in part one, obviously, all of us were discovering it together.
Yeah.
Because, see, nobody had done a war film before. Mm. All the problems we were facing were for the first time. I mean, nobody had solutions for it. We had to invent solutions and find them. But, gladly so, part one did extremely well. We were all very, very happy with overwhelmed with the result. And so it gave us a much more breather in terms of getting better technicians, not making the mistakes that we made earlier. So, if you ask Prabhas, he'll say the same thing. Where part two, the war was far more convenient to shoot. Mm. A, one is it was not in summer, so that changed. Mm-hmm. Part one, we shot the entire thing in summer, so this was a cooler in Hyderabad, then got done more specifically in time.
What about your scenes with Prabhas? Did he steal the show in the part two?
Well, I mean, see, this film, it belongs to everybody, really. Mm. Everybody in every scene has their piece, their meat. I mean, whether it's Baahubali, he is Baahubali, and it's the tale of the return of that king. Whether it's me, I own the negative, the dark part of the film. Mm. Whether it's Satyaraj or whether it's Kattappa, owns the probably the greatest question that has ever been asked in Indian cinema before. And so each one owns their piece. There's a great, great piece of Bijaladeva in the beginning of the film itself. Mm. See, the beauty of part two is you don't need introductions to these people anymore.
The characters are well etched.
You're well etched. You know all these guys. Mm. Now you just want to know what the drama is between all of them. Mm. So the film starts like almost like midpoint. Mm. So that's the real fun part about this movie.
Rajamada Sivagami Deviyin Sachiyaga Pramanam Seigiri.
As a conventional hero doing Telugu films, don't you feel that doing a villain's role doesn't
Well, so see, I mean, it's pretty much goes back to how I started things. I started doing cinema where I did films like Leader and all of them in the beginning of my career, which is not what conventional Telugu heroes do. Mm. My second film was a musician in a Goan drug racket in Dammarodam. So see, I played hero, I have now played villain, I've played character actors, I've done all of this and in multiple languages. Mm. So to me, it really becomes a character that's exciting that I'll be part of.
Yeah, you played a Bangalore days.
I did Bangalore Natkal. Mm. And see, that's something that was very endearing and very personal to me. So like that, I mean, if I like the character, I just go ahead and do it.
Okay, now what do you say about promotions? Promoting, you have been going all around the country promoting.
Yes. Well, this time I'd say this is the only time in promotions where we walk up with pride saying, here you go, you loved us in part one and we bring him back part two. Mm. And it's been enormous, the love for this film. Mm. I mean, it's something that is way beyond my understanding for sure. I've promoted films, I've promoted Hindi films, Tamil films, I've done all of this before. But this one is something I'll say. Usually you know how up north we're all looked upon. I mean, we're South Indians, there's a certain way that our cinema is looked upon. And Baahubali really changed that. I mean, Prabhas and I were in Chandigarh last week.
Yes, Chandigarh you went.
And then obviously there was a whole college who spoke Punjabi and we don't speak any of it. And the love that really this brand Baahubali got, this franchise, this film has, is far unmeasured. It really comes to show that today if somebody has a dream of making a great film, I mean, you could be in a small town in Madurai, you could be anywhere in Andhra, wherever it is. And you know, if you make a good film, there's a country out there to watch you.
Hmm. So language is no barrier.
No barrier at all. I mean, this has proved it once so clearly.
Rana, now, will you be doing more villain roles?
If they're as cool as Baahubali, yes. See, but I mean, these are things that, this is so iconic. As a villain, I don't want to do a bad one and mess it up. Mm. I mean, let them remember me as as Baahubali and not any other villain. Mm. But no, it's something that excites me. I'd really jump in and do it. Mm.
Because your selection of movies were very interesting.
Thank you, sir.
And next movie, you said you're playing a politician,
yes.
But a baddie, but not a bishum that.
No, 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 no. It's. I mean, it's inspired from like a Wolf of Wall Street type of film.
Okay.
So it's a story.
Guy.
Yeah, it's a story of a mad politician. Hmm. Yeah.
And you're the center
figure. Yeah, I'm the center figure of the film, yes.
And
it has Kajal and Catherine in the leads and Teja is directing the film.
Title?
It's Nene Razu, Nene Mantri.
Oh, but it'll have other versions?
The film is set in Anantapur, so I don't know how it'll be acceptable. I mean, I wanted some people to see it in Tamil, wanted to do a rough dub to see if it actually connects. If it does, I'd be very, very happy to put it out there.
Okay. And what about your Bollywood offers that are coming your way?
Well, after that, I have one more film which I'm shooting. That's with the director Satyasivan and K Productions. So that's a film which is set in 1945. It's a story of a soldier who fought in the Bose regiment.
Yeah.
So this year is packed. I mean, this happened till then.
That is also being done in Tamil.
Yeah, that's Tamil and Telugu. That's Tamil and Telugu. Hmm. So this year is full.
But what about Bollywood?
Well, I have a bunch of interest. See, right now I live in Hyderabad. Hmm. I'd continue. It's again for me. It was always depends on where that story takes us. Hmm. Now, Ghazi is a film that happened outside Vizag, so it becomes a Telugu film. Mm. It is a national issue, so it becomes a Hindi and a Tamil film. Mm. Now, Baahubali is a film for everybody. Mm. Now, Teja's film is a film set in Anantapur, so it it only lends itself to being a Telugu film, really.
So you don't want to...
To me, it's the film that should take its natural course.
Okay.
The other film, it's set in Madras presidency, so it becomes a Tamil and a Telugu film.
Hmm.
It does not become a Hindi film by itself.
Okay, you don't want to force it down.
I mean, it should really come from where the film is taking it.
By the way, Ghazi, outstanding.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very, very much.
Hmm.
I especially have to thank you for, and everybody else from the Chennai press who's been so, so supportive of the film. And the norm and myth of the Telugu dubbing films do not work in Chennai kind of change.
It ran very well in multiplayer.
Yeah, very, very happy with that.
Shagapatnam oda edirgalathiliyum India oda edirgalathiliyum nama nilachirpom. Jai Hind!
Jai Hind!
But with your connections and the way things are, and your buddy Mr. Karan Johar, you are all slated for a big role in Hindi.
For me, it's not, I mean, it doesn't matter if it's Hindi, Telugu or Tamil, really. It's really.
You feel after Baahubali, you have that national reach.
Well, I mean, if I have a product like it, like, why not?
Hmm.
But again, see, I'd like to do many different kinds of films.
Hmm.
See, I'd like to do small genre films. I'd like to do regional set films. And the beauty is, each industry in India offers so many different things.
Hmm.
See, like a film like Dhammarudham, I could have never done in Tamil or Telugu.
Hmm.
So that's offered by Hindi.
Hmm.
Now, if I want to set a tale in Madurai, like many Tamil films, that's something that excites me a lot. That lends itself to being a Tamil film only.
Hmm.
So I want to be part of all this cinema. I can't not be.
You find cinema exciting.
Yeah. See, that's really, the story I tell is exciting. Not.
So you're not a conventional Telugu hero who does action movies and...
Well, no, clearly not. Clearly not. I don't come from there.
Okay. And now, you are a very handsome man.
Thank
and
you, sir.
Have been linked to some of the most beautiful women.
All right.
Are you getting married?
Well, not that I know of, no. I'm not getting married anytime soon, sir, no.
Why? You want to remain a chronic bachelor?
Well, I don't know. I mean, it's fine. Whatever is... The way my life is moving, I'm pretty happy about it. So, let's see when time changes and the other direction of life is led.
Pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much, Veda. Thank you. Such a pleasure.